We got a big till against Hoosac versus Elite Hockey program here. I got about 5 minutes 30 till puck drop. Let's get ready here. Thank you. Big tilt here tonight at Lee Hockey Academy. Looks like we got a starting lineup at left wing, Brendan Kuhn. At our center, we got number 32, Dylan Contreras. And at number 37, right wing, we got Logan Nickerson here. Looks like starting left defense, Shea Theobald, number 21 starting here. Then we got number 5, Alex Tonino, right defense here.
Starting in net for the Elite Hockey Academy, we got number 30, Nick Junkin.
Looks like for Hoosac School, we got starting left wing, number 15, Cole Elwood. At center, number 25, we got Ethan McDonough. At right wing, we got number 17, Daniela Lakil. Starting right defense on Hoosac School, we got Dom Metro. Starting left defense, number 23, Alex Panamino. And then starting goaltender, number 33, Ben Williams. Looks like we got a change in goaltending for Lee Hockey Academy. Looks like Cade Corbin will be starting. Starting puck drop, looks like it goes to Hoosac School.
Shea Theobald coming down. Puck's in deep here by Lee Hockey Academy.
Hoosac chip down out of the zone to Shea Theobald. Down to Daniel Berg, back to Shea. Disruption. Big hit there by number 7 on Hoosac. Puck chips out. Number 20, captain on Hoosac School. Logan Nickerson coming down on a 3-on-1. Shot and miss. Got number 16 coming down. Chip, pucks in deep. Looks like you got a little rush here by number 6. Oh. Big disruption by Alex Tonino.
Let's go. One-on-one here with Grant Amerlini. Shot, miss.
Kenny puck slow. West Coquet coming in. Hit. West Coquet coming in. Pass in front of net. Alex Tonino. Oh, just missed one. Grant Amerlini coming down. It's Alex Tonino. Tonini. My fault. Michael Marquez got the puck down low. Goalie came out. Michael Marquez coming down with the puck. A lot of physical start here in this game. Puck's in deep. West Coquet. We got a fork. Looks like Lee Hockey Academy is running a neutral zone trap. Dylan Contreras on in a one-on-one.
Big defensive play by number, looks like number 10 there. Dylan Contreras coming down. Pass, Brendan Kuhn. Goal! Scored by Brody True. True Crew on YouTube. Go like and subscribe. Looks like Brody True got the goal there, assisted by number 10, Brendan Kuhn. Face off here, won by Lee Hockey Academy, back to Hoosac School. Daniel Berg coming down, leading the breakout. Brendan Kuhn with the chip to Jack Doherty. Down to Nick Fall. 2-on-1. Jack Doherty with the goal. What a play by Jack Doherty to get open in front of the net. Jack Doherty got the big call up today from the 0-4 team. Wait, face off here, won by Hoosac School. To number 6. Big dangle in the neutral zone. Looks like Hoosac School has a lot of people out of their lineup right now. Big hit by Logan Nickerson, getting the crowd going. A lot of physicality early in the game here with a 2-0 lead at Lee Hockey Academy. Number 2, Jack Bedier with the puck. Pass it on over to Daniel Berg. Lee needs to get the puck out here. Big hit by Logan Nickerson. A lot of scrapping. Tim Mattingly, number 34, number 6. Look like there's a bunch of scraps right now. Big opportunity here. Tim Mattingly. It's Alex Tornini. Tim Mattingly with the puck. Down to Nate Perezik. Hits the crossbar. Alex Tonini, former Westminster player. To Michael Marquez on the boards here. Up to Nate Perezik. Big block shot at number 7. Oh. As number 9 takes the ref down there. 29. Big dangles here, getting the puck out of the zone, Alex Tornini. Number 19 coming down with the puck for Hoosac School. Number 16 getting pucks deep here. Number 8, smaller player. Hoosac goalie coming out with it. Gives it up to look at number 16 there. Getting pucks out. Big physical play by Grant Emerlini. Pucks in deep here at number 16 on Hoosac School. Got number 25 on Hoosac, beating him to it. He has a guy opening the slot. Chip down. Luke Stevens taking a big hit. Adam Coley, big breakout pass to Brendan Kuhn, number 10. To Dylan Contreras, zooming through. Nice little fake scissor play to Luke Stevens. Passing down low, looks like a Lee Hockey Academy. They're buzzing here, they're buzzing. We got True Crew getting the puck low. Dylan Contreras, big dangles. In front, shot. Oh, big save. Got a one-on-one opportunity by Hoosac. They're getting it deep, not taking any chances here. Looks like we got Luke Stevens with the puck, big dangle. Taking it down the ice, mishandled. Pucks in deep here. Brendan Kuhn forechecking. We got Jack Doherty hustling. He's hustling. Fellow 16-year member hustling. Shea Theodore, down low with Michael Marquez. Jeff Verdier. Oh, Brennan Kuhn with the big one-time blast. Face-off win here by Hoosac School. Puck's in low here. We got a one-on-two chance. Big back check, big hit by Jack Badir. Ali is digging, trying to get the puck out. Trying to get out of the zone. Puck up top, number 20, then 23 on Hoosac. Shot. Big save by Kate Corbin. Rebound. Oh, big save. Pucks it low here, looking good for Hoosac School. We got a lot of boards play, a lot of physical activity here. Shea Theobald's quarterback in this play. To the pocket, Nick Fall, pucks in deep. We're calling an ice there. Not sure if that was the right call or not. We got a 2-0 lead if you're just tuning in now. Lee Hockey Academy is up 2-0 with 10 minutes, 40 seconds left in the first. We got a face-off here, big hit, Michael Roby. We got a mishandled puck, Tim Mattingly coming down to Roby. To Nate, missed shot. Roby coming down to Tim Mattingly, they're cycling the puck. Looks like we got a penalty here, or a stoppage of play. Looks like a hand pass on Hoosac School. Again, out of zone faceoff for Lee Hockey Academy. Michael Roby coming down. Getting the puck low down to Tim Mattingly, number 34. Up to the D, back. Got number 25 coming on an opportunity for Hoosac School. Big save by Cade Corbin. Logan Nicholson down with the puck. Looks like we got it to Ratache. Alex Tonini quarterback in this breakout to Tim Mattingly. Back to Nate, Michael Roby, pucks in deep. We got Logan Nickerson on the forecheck here. Michael Marquez helping him out. Good support. Comes back to Grant Amorlini, number 97. Shot blocked. Big hit down low by Michael Marquez. Looks like there's some chippy play here. On both ends of the ice. Big shot, big save, number 33. Hoosac got the puck out. Luke Stevens coming down. Chip play to Grant Amorlini. Wes Coquet with a big poke. Wes Coquet, opportunity. Hoosac keeps it in. Number 23, big shot, miss. Number 20 with a big slap shot. Pucks in low by Hoosac School here. Grant and Merlini throws the puck back into the zone. Players tripping over one another. Pucks in deep here by Hoosac School. Wes Coquet. To Luke Stevens. Brendan Kuhn forechecking here. They're calling a no ice here. We got a big hit down low here. Big breakout play to number 8. No ice call here. Looks like Kate Corbin's won in that call. Front opportunity, miss. Looks like we got a player down here. Looks like we got an injured player here. We got Coach Peter Alden coming out to help him. Looks like it's Daniel Berg here with the injury. Not sure if there's a call here or not, but looks like Daniel Berg is still on the ice. Looks like he's starting to get up here. Got stick taps here for Daniel Berg. Not sure if he's going to be playing the remaining of the game, but he's up. Something you just truly hate to see, right, Tommy?
That's exactly right, Nolan.
Looks like we've got a defensive zone faceoff here at Elite Hockey Academy. Looks like there was no penalty. Number 5. Cover puck by Cade Corbin. Splendid music choice here by Evan Hears and TJ Kupek on the 15U. Jack Vinier with the puck to True. Looking for the puck out. We got Dylan Contreras on a 2-on-2. Dangling through. Going wide. Shot. Goal! Scored by number 32, Dylan Contreras. What a shot. We got a 3-0 lead here with 7 minutes left in the first period.
And Elite Hockey Academy is just buzzing on all cylinders.
We're buzzing on all cylinders, like my partner just said. Amazing individual effort. Looks like we got a faceoff win by Hoosac score here. Adam McCoy with the puck. Luke Stevens. Got it up to Troy. Hoosac turnover. No offsides. Oh, offsides call there. Off win by Elite Hockey Academy here. We got Adam Coley with the puck, sending it down low. Looks like we got Troy, number 18, with the puck down low, down to Nick Fall. Adam Coley pitching hard on number 26. Nick Fall down low. Battling for the puck. It's an absolute battle down there.
They're going at each other.
Looks like a lot of chippy behavior going on. Elite comes out with the puck. To Liam Dolphin, number 29, fellow 60U player as well. Nick Fall with the puck, opportunity pass. Oh, big disruption by Hoosac School. Hoosac with the puck. Number 6, big disruption by Logan Nickerson. Huge Danbury hat tricks commit. Puck's deep, Logan Nickerson. Look at Nickerson with the puck down low. Michael Roby digging the puck out. Elite comes out with it to Alex Tonini. Shot, pass. Not sure what that was. Tim Mattingly with the puck here, keeping it in the zone. Michael Roby digging in out for safety. Michael Roby with the puck. Hoosac coming out with that battle. Number 3 to number 8. Number 11 on Hoosac here. We got a 2-on-2 going on. Big disruption play by Michael Roby. It's like a 2-on-2 here with the back checker. Offsides. Got a face-off win by Lee Hockey Academy here. Alex Tonini coming down with the puck. The Grand Merlini. Shipped down low. Michael Marquez. Sorry about that disruption here. Dangles down low by Wesco K. Down to Alex Tonini. Nate Terzic, number 12, coming down. Shot, block. Big battle by the boards in the O zone here for Lee Hockey Academy. We got Alex Tonino with the puck. Oh, turnover. Looks like we got an opportunity here for Hoosac School. Shot, miss, in the netting. Towards the end of the first period here, we got 4 minutes, 45 seconds left. Elite Hockey Academy with a 3-0 lead here. Off win. Looks like a big chip out right here by Lee Hockey Academy. Opportunity, Brennan Kuhn. Hoosac comes out with it. Hoosac chips the puck out here. And it's an icing. A Hoosac face-off win here. Looks like this is a 1-on-2 here. Shot, big save by Cade Corbin. Dylan Contreras coming out with it to Roby, back to True Crew. Net drive here by Dylan Contreras. Disruption play. Shade Theobald, number 21, with the puck down the boards. Looks like Hoosac's coming out with it, number 15. Jack Peter coming out. Jack Peter with the puck. Nice little move there. Disruption play. Inside of the zone. Looks like a 2-on-0 here. Six. Big save by Cade Corbin. Number 6 with the puck. Oh, big play. Shot. Big save by Cade Corbin. 11 with the puck. Up high. D-D-D pass, number 10. We need this puck out. Big save by Cade Corbin once again. And there's a stoppage of play. He is on his toes.
Correct.
Minutes 10 left of the period here. We got Jack Doherty on the faceoff. Jack Doherty, a big faceoff win to Adam Coley. Down to Luke Stevens. Down looks like to Troy Guevia. Huge dangles by number 20, Theon Hoosac. Nick Fall with the puck. Looks like we got assistant captain of the puck. Luke Stevens digging. It's a battle down low right now. Chip play by Troy. Nick ball with the puck. Couldn't reach it to get out. Puck down low in the elite zone here. Adam Coley with the puck to Nick Paul. Missed shot on number three. Logan Nickerson, chip play. Michael Roby. Number 14 with the puck. Number six coming down. Logan Nickerson with the puck. Passes to Tim Mattingly. We got an opportunity here. Finally, we're getting some offense here. Yeah, up high, number 12. Tick. Big save here at number 33. Big bomb here. Michael Roby coming down. Nice little block shot there, getting out of the zone. Hoosac school coming down with the puck. Kate Corbin trying to get the puck out of the zone. Michael Roby, slap shot, big save by Kate Corbin. Puck is flying out of the zone here. Look like an offside from this angle, but I'll let the refs ref the game. Ooh, we got a big dangle by Tim Mattingly here. We got players in front of the net. Up high to Alex Tonini. Number five. Shot. Big save. Huge glove.
Starting to heat up here, folks.
Game is starting to heat up here. We got some New York drill. Played by TJ Kupak and Evan Hughes here. Jack Doherty with a face-off. Graham Merlini to Alex Tonini. Getting the puck low. Looks like Wes Coquet coming down. Nice little scissor play by Graham Merlini. Coming down. Looks like number 25 came out with it on Hoosac school. Nice little pass to 15. Textbook chip in there. Truly textbook. Wesco K coming out with the puck. Trying to get to Graham Merlini. Doesn't quite reach him. Alex Tonini with a big stop. Wesco K coming down to Graham Merlini. We got a, let's get a 1-on-3 here. Big shot and just missed. We got Jack Madeira and we got a stoppage of play here. Not sure what the call is. Still not sure what this call was. Looks like nobody's in the penalty box here. We got a center ice faceoff here. Dylan Contreras with the draw. Lee came out with it. Luke Stevens with the puck. To Brandon Kuhn, number 10. The man from Dallas. Shot. Blocked. We got Chu Kuhn coming down on the pressure. Brandon Kuhn sending it back down low. Number 23, Hoosac came out with it. Chukwu is not giving up, forechecking. We got an end of the period here. 3-0 elite. End of the first period here. Number 99 Hoosac with a big mullet. Ultimate style.
I'm here with British Columbia Tiger Cats CFL football player Sheridan Lawley, also teacher at Elite Hockey Academy. Sheridan, tell me, how is it teaching us here at Elite?
It's a great opportunity. You know, the coaching staff, the players are great. Great facilities. Kids just want to learn, which is the best part of it. So couldn't be happier.
You heard it here. Kids just want to learn here at Elite Hockey Academy. Inquire now. All right, Sheridan. How do you think the game's going so far in the first period?
Yeah, I mean, I think we started off hot. You know, we rallied off those two quick goals. But I think what we need to focus on right now is just a lack of complacency. You know, great teams, they don't play to the level of their competition, whether that's playing up or playing down. So I think going into the second period, it's just playing our own game and then, you know, keep rolling. I'm here with Nolan Cole, one of the superstars here on the U15 team. What are your thoughts? What are your thoughts on the game so far? And if there's anything that you would correct as a coach, let's hear it.
What I'd say is I think Elite's doing a great job. I mean, they're getting on the board very well, executing opportunities. Looks like their net drive is very good. Like we practice here at a lot of Elite, stomping on the net. I've seen a lot of that. Some things I think if I was a coach I'd want to work on with the team is I really just think getting the puck out of the zone a little quicker and just making the right play, headman in the puck, and just making some more simple plays.
Who's your favorite player on the 18U team and why?
That's a tough question. I'm going to have to go with Grant Emerlini, number 97. He's a pretty funny kid. I think he brings a mood up in the classroom and in the locker room.
So he's a morale guy. He's a good locker room player.
I'd say so. Yes.
Awesome. Awesome. If you would describe your gameplay, like one player in the NHL, who would you say that is?
I don't think my gameplay matches with anyone right now. I mean, I'm kind of a grinder. I like to get physical, get the pucks deep.
So what you're saying is the league has never seen a player like you before.
I'm a different breed. What can I say? I'm built different.
You heard it here, folks. Nolan Cole, U15 Elite Hockey.
Looks like we got Logan Nickerson out here starting to draw. Got Michael Roby on left wing here and Tim Attenby on the right side. Sticks are out. Fans are going crazy here. Puck goes to Adam Coley, number 7, Luke Stevens. Chip. Big hit there. Logan Nickerson coming down with the puck, getting it low. Number 20 on Hoosac coming out with it. Intercepted by Michael Roby. Tim Attenby with the puck. Looks like, oh. What a play. Number 22 coming out with the puck. Number 16. Number 16 is absolutely wheeling down. Chipping pucks in. Hoosac with not a lot of forecheck, not a lot of presence here. We got Michael Roby coming down. Oh, huge single. Huge single. Oh.
That shot is just tipped out of the rink by Hoosac defenseman.
Great play. Textbook.
Got a face-off here by Wesco K.
Wesco K coming out with the puck to Nate Harrison. Michael Marquez to Wesco K. Block shot by number 10 on Hoosac here.
Alex Tonini with the shot.
Number 10 coming down with it. Wesco K. Huge play in front of the net. Michael Marquez just dumping it in front of the net. Number 17 coming out with the puck, trying to tip it out.
Elise doing a good job keeping the puck in the zone here.
Nate, number 12 with the puck. Down to Alex Tonini. Down to Grant Merlini. Two dangles. Two whole dangles. Jack Bedier keeping the puck in, and it is offsides. Hoosac number 3 with the puck here. Look at the flow on this kid. Dumped in. Kate Corbin with the puck. Coming down. Shoe crew. Deflected by the ref there. We'll take it. Dylan Contreras with the puck. It's a 4-on-2 here. Dylan Contreras coming down. Shot. Big blocker save just by Hoosac goalie. Just off the goalie's knob. Chukru with the puck here on the blue line. Oh, number 6 is trying to absolutely body him. Chukru is not going anywhere. Chip down low here. Dylan Contreras with the puck in center ice here. Drive wide, driving to the net. Big shade here by number 33 by Hoosac. Jack Doherty with the draw here. Great tune, great tune. Jack Doherty with the chance in front, Liam Delphin. Number 8 with the puck, driving wide, chipped in deep. Number 2, Jack Bedier. Oh, dangerous play in front of the net by Jack Bedier. Just misses wide of the net. Alini's got this puck out of the zone here. Hoosac. Big tip by number, looks like number 15, assistant captain. Huge hit by number 16. That is a big hit. Number 23, chip. Big hit by Liam Gelfin. Jack Doherty coming down, one-on-one, shot.
Looking for his second goal of the game there, just gets tipped wide.
Just gets tipped wide.
Jack Doherty, actually a 16-year player, looking good, getting some shifts and getting the huge call-up. He's just playing well.
Yeah, we got a couple call-ups here, including number 18, Troy. I don't know how to say his last name. And then we got Liam Gelfin, number 29 here. We got number 14 on Hoosac here, big pass to number 17, getting it out.
We got Logan Nickerson with the face-off right now. We got Michael Roby on the wing here. Face-off win. Oh, looks like Hoosac in it. To Michael Roby. Big dangle in the middle of the net. Big pass to Luke Stevens. Shot. Just misses wide. Logan Nickerson with the puck. Chips it low.
Tim Mattingly with the puck on the side. Has a lot of room to work with here. Huge tangle in front. Shot. Big save. Huge save. Oh, the puck is loose. Puck is out of the zone here. Cade Corbin coming out to play the puck here.
Luke Stevens is going to reset with it here.
Luke Stevens is going to reset here. Logan Nickerson with the puck. Michael Richards is back to him. Pass. Tim Mattingly. Opportunity in front. Big save. Number 7 on Hoosac here with the chance. Cade Corbin is out of the net. Big save by Cade Corbin. And he takes a big spill in the boards. Logan Nickerson chips the puck to number 14. Shot just missed wide here. Another time with the puck.
But I feel like the pace of this game has just picked up greatly in the past couple minutes here with the physical play.
It really has. The speed looks better. Everything looks better. It's very physical, nice and chippy. Just how I like it. West Coquet with a face-off here. Looks like we got Jack Doherty on the draw here. Oh, it's West Coquet, my bad. Both number 6. Grant Emerly with the puck, coming down. He's absolutely wheeling. Big cutback play to Alex Sonini. Back to Grant Emerly, getting the puck down low here. Number 18, chipping the puck down to number 7. There pairs it, looks like West Coquet. And intercepted play by number 6. Number 7, almost had a big breakaway there. Little misread pass. Got an offensive zone faceoff here for Lee Hockey Academy. West Coquet with the draw, lost. Number 23 coming down with the puck. Chips low. 19 on the forecheck here. 16 on the other side. Huge hit by number 16. He is a big boy. He is a big boy. Number 16 is just taking bodies out. Huge role in the team. Number 12 coming down with the puck. Grant Merlini. Chipped up top to Nate Perisic. Nate Perisic with a dangle. Shot. And it's in the netting. Face off here by Dylan Contreras. One to Brendan Kuhn, middle of the ice. Oh, nice little change-up shot there. Great edge work by Brendan Kuhn. Coming down, shake table, and the puck is out of the zone. Looks like Cade Corbin will handle it. To Jack Beneer, handling it behind the net. Jack Beneer is taking him out. Up to Brendan Kuhn. True crew forechecking. Brendan Kuhn keeping it in the zone. Toe drag shot. And it's just wide. Puck is out of play here. Look at Jarrett's right face up here. Puck is in Hoosac's possession. Behind the net, they're breaking it out here. Number 11. Chips it back into their zone. Number 3 with the puck here. Duncan Trent keeping it in. Looks like a Lee has possession here. Puck is in front of the net. Number 3 trying to chip it out. Huge pinch play by Shea. Number 10, Van Kuhn with the puck. Faking everyone out. Dangles. Brandon Coons coming down. Jack Vidi with the puck. Dylan Contreras. Nice little scissor play. Looks like it was to Nick Fall there. Number 10 on Hoosac School coming down. Chipped out of play. Brandon Coons keeping the puck in. No offsides there.
Missed pass. It was looking like a free 2-on-1 there, but instead it's going to be an icing for the Hoosac School. They can't get any offense going.
You heard it here. It's unfortunate. Got a face off by 16U player Liam Dolphin here. As we're seeing, baby, I'm. Alright, so we got Liam Dolphin coming down in the corner. Up to Luke Stevens. Troy was in front of the net there, couldn't get a tip on it. Adam Coley keeping him in. Looks like Jack Dory in the corner digging the puck. Is that Jack Dory? I think it is. He's an absolute horse down low. That is Nick Fall. Nick Fall himself. Luke Stevens coming down. Passes it low. Get it up top. A lot of physical play in the corners here. Captain. Captain number 20 who's like school. Right into the netting. Logan Nickerson with a face-off here. Michael Roby getting up top, number 12. They're down to 34 to Mattingly. Michael Roby digging. Big shot. Good save at number 33. Number 18 with the puck here, trying to pick the puck out. Number 17. Big miss hit there by Tim Mattingly. Alex Romini getting pucks deep here. There's been no scoring this period so far with 10 minutes left. Huge hit to Mattingly there. Huge hit by number 18. Logan Nickerson keeping it down low. Looks like his teammate was looking for a change there. Huge opportunity, 25 getting the puck down low until lead 10. Huge disruption by number 5, Alex Tonini. Hoosac School, number 17 coming down. Puck is out. Number 10, PDD pass to 22. Michael Marquez keeping it in. Great hand-eye coordination there by Michael Marquez. Grant Merlina trying to keep the puck in. Grant Merlina coming down, shot, just missed Grant. Grant Merlina down low again. Michael Marquez with the puck. Gets sandwiched by two Hoosac School members. Hoosac is trying to break the puck out. We got 2-on-1, but this back check is unreal. Amazing play by Wesco K there. Absolutely textbook. Shea coming out with the puck. Shea is absolutely reeling with the puck. We got Michael Marquez on a 3-on-3 here. Wesco K. Jack Benier, shot, tip, huge save by number 33.
Lee Hockey Academy, but number 33 from Hoosac gonna come stuffing it. And oh my God, here we've got a goalie change. Number 33 coming out, number 1 coming in. We'll see if this changes the pace or the attitude of the Hoosac School players. Maybe get some goals on the board.
Who knows? Who knows what's coming in here?
Who knows? You can't tell. Hoosac goalie looks mad on the bench, probably because he gave up 3 easy goals.
Hoosac goalie is mad. Hoosac goalie is mad. Dylan Contreras with a faceoff here. Pokes it out. We got Hoosac coming out with the puck. We got a big pitch by Adam Cooley. Didn't quite work there. Brandon Kuhn looking for that hip check. Dylan Contreras coming down, swimming through people. Can't quite get it. Luke Stevens, huge move one. Nice little cold direct pass there. Brannigan with the puck up top, chips it down low. Hoosac is trying to break this puck out. A lot of physical play there. Brannigan Kuhn. With the puck, trying to break it out. Dangles by number 23. Dangles City, but does not go through Elite's defense. Luke Stevens with the puck behind the net. Wraps it around Adam Coley, the man from California. Brandon Kuhn with an opportunity. True crew. Oh. Number six hitting True Crew there. True Crew is hurt. Brody True is hurt.
This is the second Lee Hockey Academy player we've seen get hurt this game. You really hate to see this. He's grabbing his leg. Looks like he's writhing in pain on the ground. You really hope this is going to be okay.
This is not a good play here. Bad knee to the head.
Bad knee to the head. He looks like he's grabbing his leg here. I don't know if there's any penalty on this. I'm not one to judge. We got Coach Alden coming out here to check on him. Looks like it was number six on Hoosac School over there who hit him. Stick tap for True Crew.
We'd love to see this. We'll probably see a YouTube video out on True Crew tonight. You know, maybe you should subscribe.
I think you should. Hoosac players in the box over here.
Still gonna be a 5-on-4 though.
Looks like it's gonna be a 5-on-4. Looks like we got a power play unit here. Dylan Contreras is out here with Wesco K and Michael Roby. It's up to Shea Theodore. Wesco K here. And, looks like it's the right wing side. Dylan Contreras up top. Luke Stevens with the puck. Dylan Contreras. He's dangling through. Nice pass to Wesco K. Shoot it, Luke Stevens. Michael Roby. Oh, big miss. Luke Stevens, big pass to Wesco K. Huge block by number 18. Michael Roby with the puck. Wesco K down low. What is he going to do with it? Luke Stevens shot. Just missed.
The Elite Hockey power play looks like it's some sort of end zone overload.
We got a missed breakout pass there. Hoosac, number 19 with the opportunity. Looks like we got a loose stick. Looks like there's a penalty. looks like we got a penalty by number 19 here. Taking his frustrations out on Luke Stevens, it looks like. Looks like we got a 5-on-3 here. Perfect time for Elite to put some points up on the board. Looks like Elite's coming out with the puck here. We got Tim Mattingly coming out to Nate. Nice little ball. Little neutral zone breakout play here. Tim Mattingly coming down. Chip down low. Should have been an interference there. Brandon Kuhn coming down with the puck. Adam Coley down to Nate. Tim Mattingly, looks like the puck, oh, big save by Adam Coley here. Nate Perisic down to Adam Coley. What's he gonna do with it? What's he gonna do with it? Tim Mattingly, Brandon Kuhn, shot, just misses. Logan Nickerson with the puck, to Adam Coley. Back to Nickerson, the Dan Barry hat-trick. Adam Coley, to Tim Mattingly, shot, Brandon Kuhn, big save by number one here. He's looking pretty good. I think that goalie change is going to benefit them. Shot, blocked, rebound.
Wow.
The puck is loose. The puck is in. Logan Nickerson, the Danbury hat-trick himself, has scored. The tender player himself. Amazing power play goal. Huge group effort by Elite Hockey Academy.
Just to be clear for the kids at home, that goal at the tail end of the second penalty, so now it's going to be a 5-on-4.
Well said, Thomas.
For the kids at home.
Dylan Contreras here with the center ice. Got Elite Hockey Academy with a 4-0 lead here with 5 minutes left in the second period. True domination. Luke Stevens here with the puck to Michael Roby. We got Dylan Contreras wheeling. He's going wide. Huge dangle. Huge dangle.
Dylan Contreras working behind the net here.
Working around their whole zone for that matter. Dylan Contreras, a nice little Mohawk flip there. That is something that we emphasize at the Elite Hockey Academy. That's Luke Stevens. Back to Dylan Contreras. They are playing keep away with the puck right now. Huge play in front of the net. Big disruption.
Back door look there, couldn't go through it. Now, if the Hoosac school is going to be able to ice this puck down, kill some of this penalty time. What do you think about that power play?
It looks really good to me. I mean, it's been working, right? They put up a point. Good. Huge hit down low. Looks like a Hoosac player is hurt. That is the third player this game that is hurt. Oh, he got right back up. Huge tough guy.
He's a trooper.
He is a trooper. Looks like we got a penalty at Elite Hockey Academy by Shane Theodore, number 21. quick. We got Troy face off here. Quick stop of play. We got an offensive zone face-off for Hoosac School here. Huge win, number 8. Clearing the puck right away, pinching up. Liam Guffin with a big hit up top. Number 7 coming down with the puck. Nice little draw pass play to 23. Shot, big save by Kid Corbin. 11 with the puck here, making cutback plays. To 23, huge shot, big block. Hoosac able to hold it in. They got a nice little power play going on here. Huge save by Kate Corbin.
That puck is gloved down.
That puck is gloved down.
Kate Corbin, you know, as a goalie myself, that's just a great save. Textbook, really, just looking through the traffic. Really calm in net tonight.
Yeah, I agree.
Right, Trent?
Oh, yeah.
We got a rush here by Michael Marquez. He just chips it down and he is forechecking for the puck. Looks like he might beat him here. Michael Marquez, an absolute horse down low. But he's absolutely wheeling. A lot of physical action happening on the boards here. Adam Coley just reading, just absolutely reading the body there. Nate Harrison, huge dump. We got stick tapped at the New Hockey Academy bench here.
Staying up with the puck, quarterback in this play. He'll take it wide.
Puck is in front of that. Here's saved by Kate Corbin. Could that be a goal?
I don't think that's a goal. I don't think that's a goal.
Definitely not. Kate Corbin looking sharp, even under the stressful times.
It's a big stoppage of play here. I'm not sure what's going on. Looks like there's a 2-minute penalty here. Hoosac School. We have 4-on-4. Luke Stevens hit with the puck. Tip it down low to Tim Mattingly. Tim Mattingly is wheeling. Number 10 caught up to the puck there. D-to-D play. Number three with the puck. Tim Mattingly with the opportunity. Oh, that can miss. Logan Nicholson coming out with the puck.
Some say it's the best part of hockey. I would have to agree. The skill can just really shine through.
Honestly, Tommy, I don't know who says that.
A lot of people.
Big spill by number 3. Number 16 with the puck. Number 16 absolutely wheeling down the ice. It's a 5-on-4 right now. Looks like a Lee Hockey Academy with the power play. Dylan Contreras coming down. Stealing the puck from number 19. There's a 3-on-1. Michael Roby with the pass. Huge save.
What a stop by the Hoosac 10.
What a shot by Logan Nickerson. Shot.
Big save. Number 1 coming up huge here.
Looks like this goalie change can really benefit them.
Number 1 is absolutely feeling it right now. Able to smother up the play, calm it down a little bit.
Got some little baby going. We got number 32, Dylan Contreras with the face-off here. Adam Coley with the puck. Michael Roby. Dylan Contreras with the puck down low. Let's go there, puck in front. Adam Coyle with the puck, gets it down low to Contreras. Adam Coyle keeps the puck in to Michael Roby. Huge interception play. There is a 2-on-0. 2-on-0, number 17. Kate and Tobin. He misses the net!
Wow. Honestly embarrassing for the Hoosac school.
Highly embarrassing if you ask me. Cade Corbin is just that intimidating. Great goalie here from Minnesota.
Go. Here they go back the other way.
2-on-1.
2-on-1.
Dylan Contreras. Shut in on
just
this!
Just wide. And the net's off here. We should get a stop at the play.
Roscoe Cam. Preventing that play. And there's a stop at the play. Looks like the pegs are off the net. There's a lot of chattering from the referee here.
Almost a great play by Dylan Contreras. Can't forget the assist too. Great sauce. If that worked, that would have been sick.
Max. Logan Nickerson with the faceoff here for Lee Hockey Academy. One draw. Alex Tonini getting pucks deep here. The man from Dallas, very physical down low. Tim Mattingly, forechecking. Hoosac trying to get the puck out. Lenniker keeping it in. Tim Mattingly up top, Alex Tonini coming down. Logan Nickerson is forechecking down low. He just took a huge spill. They're calling a penalty. I'm not sure on which side here. Looks like he tried to hit him, got kind of rebounded by Logan Nickerson.
Looks like it's going to be on the Elite Hockey Academy. Just with 20 seconds left here in the second, which means this is going to bleed over to the third. We'll see how this goes for them.
Check out Mikey Marquez on the face-off here. Puck will be in Hoosac's possession here. Hoosac is coming down wide. Stop by Shea Thibault. Looks like Graham Molina with the opportunity here. Oh, and he caught out of motion there. Mikey Marquez with the puck. That's it deep. 2 seconds left, 1 second left, and that's the end of the second period.
Mike Marquez arguing with the official here. Thinks he was interfered with, but who knows?
Yes, we will never know. End of the second period here. 1 minute, 40 seconds left on the penalty here by Logan Nickerson. And it looks like Elite Hockey Academy has a 4-0 lead. Looks like Brody Chew's having a hard time getting off the ice. Looks like he needs Nicholas Junkin, number 30, and Michael Roby, number 11, to assist him. Brody Chew barely able to stand at 1 foot right now. Trying to get off the ice here.
Here we are coming at you guys with some third period action. Players are just starting to get back onto the ice, stretching out. We're starting this period at 18 minutes, 4-0 Elite Hockey Academy. 1 minute, 40 seconds only left for Elite Hockey Academy. It's going to be a 5-on-4 for Hoosac School.
Captain number 20 here coming down with the puck, getting it low. Kay Corbin with the cover. Number 11, Hoosac School coming down with the puck. Number 7, guys, down low. Corbin covering this post for the ball here.
Nate
with a carry attack. That's where he thinks he's going to puck in. Just a mishandled puck there. The puck is out of the zone. Who exactly will recover it? We got number 11 quarterback in this play. Drop pass to number 20. Dylan Contreras will interrupt it. He is digging. Dylan Contreras with the puck. Dangling the puck down low.
Corbin is putting on a clinic down in the offensive zone on a penalty kill.
Number 7, Hoosac School coming down, puck wide. Shot, big block by Shea. Number 23 with the puck down low. Number 11, the puck up top. One timer by number 10. Too much traffic in the way. Adam McCauley digging the puck, he's trying to get it out. Look at Travis with a clear. Number 10 will recover the puck down low. Number 7 with the puck here. Shifting it wide to number 11. Nick Fall with an opportunity here, going wide. Nick Fall might have this opportunity coming. Puck down low. That's okay, we'll cover it. That's okay, we'll puck down low right now. I'm going with the puck. Beautiful DDD pass to Luke Stevens. Slap shot. Just missed. Adam Cooley. Try to chip the puck. Low. Failed attempt. Luke Stevens coming down the ice. Dangle. Dangle City. Big save by number 1. This goaltender change has helped them. Let's go, Kay. Possessing the puck on low. Puck cleared out. Luke Stevens, Adam Cooley. Cooley going down wide. Chip play to Grant Merlini. Michael Marquez coming to cover. Let's think about three players in the puck right now. Number 15. Skating the puck wide. Tries to get a 25 field attempt. Elite defense looks up. Unstoppable right now. Huge save by Kid Corbin, number 33. Got 15-13 left. Here, Elite winning 4-0 if you're just tuning in. Huge face-off win here by Dylan Contreras.
Definitely get it from the fuck down low. Ship play to Merlin. Brennan Kuhn. Huge big up pass to Brennan Kuhn. Now entering the zone. He's cutting middle. Classic Bill Contreras. Back.
And a two-goal exchange by number 9 on the Elite Hockey Academy. Wow, that's some skill being displayed.
Nick Fall with a great between the legs play there. Big save by Trey Tompkins there. Brennan Kuhn with the chip out. Bill Contreras actually wheeling on that forecheck. Will he recover the puck? No. Knife team with the puck. Looks like the assistant captain who's at school. Alex Sonina. Welcome up, Cavs, digging the puck down low. We got Shea Theodore back in this play. Only looks like they're on a power play right now. Elite's resetting the puck down low. Troy, number 18 with the puck. Chipped out. Nate Perisic. Play Liam Delphin. Jack Gordon needs to play down low. Huge battle down low right now on Hoosac's defensive end. Hoosac will come out with the puck. Number 16 with it on the boards. Huge pass number 19, it's mishandled. Elite has possession. Pucks in deep, chipped in. Logan Nickerson out of the penalty box. To Mattingly with the puck. Looks like there's a lot of scrubbing on the boards right there in front of Hoosac's bench. Logan Nickerson with the puck, pass to Michael Roby, and it's mishandled. Cycling the puck down to Logan Nickerson. Down to Shea on the defensive end. Michael Roby with a one-time shot and saved by Trey Tompkins. Big hit attempt by Tim Mattingly there. Got Logan Nickerson coming down the ice, skating wide. Huge dangle play. And he just got rocked by number 6. Things are heating up in this zone right now. Nate Perisic keeping the puck in. Logan Nickerson looks angry right now. Tim Mattingly with the puck. In front of that, Michael Roby. Luke Stevens. Looks like Adam Cole with the defenseman will recover low.
The Hoosac school just can't seem to get any offense going. Can't even get it out of their own zone without icing the puck. This is just utter domination by the Hockey Academy. That one batted out of the air by number 11.
Logan Nickerson looks very mad right now. He's digging.
Boy, angry boys score goals.
Yes. Luke Stevens with the puck. Nice pass to Michael Roby. Michael Roby in front of net. Shot.
What? Smothered by Trey Tompkins.
Right in the chest. Looks like we got Wesco K, Graham Merlini, and Michael Marquez out right now. Wesco K with a faceoff here. Lost. Hoosac's possession. That'll be icing. We're just tuning in. 4-0 lead right now in the third period with 11 minutes, 44 seconds left. Let's go, okay, with a face-off here. Brandon Murray with a shot. Big block by number 18 there. Alex Tonino. Fuck. Tonini, my bad. Jack Vitter with the puck. Picked up the board. Grant Merlini. Recovered by Hoosac School. Looks like Elias is reeling the puck down low right now. Jack Vitter with the puck. Looks like he'll send it down. Jack Vitter with the recover. Into the net, Grant Merlini. Missed play opportunity there. Awesome, Emmy. It's almost like a holding there. Hoosac School is very critical right now. Wesco K with a big hit. got absolutely rebounded. He's on the ground. Osko K is arguing with the ref here. He is very mad. Looks like they got them both here. Looks like number 10 on Hoosac School and Osko K will be in the box. Looks like it'll still be 5-on-5 here. 5-on-5 here. Hoosac will recover possession. They're coming down number 6 in wide, bumps the puckin. Beautiful pick up pass to Dylan Kuhn. Back to Dylan Katrance. Dangles for the stick. We got players crashing in the net here. Who's that? That's Brendan Kuhn with a big backhand play. Stopper to play here.
The official's calling something. We don't know what it is yet, but we'll find out in just a second. 6 left in the third period.
10:26 left in the third period. Don't address my ozone face off here. Okay, do it all. I have the puck coming down wide. Troy Gouveia with the puck line. Mishandled. Jack Doherty recovered. Back to Troy Gouveia. Number 6 on Hoosac with the puck down low. He's absolutely winning. Trying to absolutely body Troy. Hoosac with the puck down low.
Oh, I just noticed it. This is an all 16 new call-up line from the Elite Hockey Academy.
Yeah, honestly, I think it's pretty impressive what they can do. Congrats to them. I mean, getting called up, it's a big deal. Playing a prep team. He has got the fuck out low. He just shook like 4 guys off of him. He did a lot of physical play down low. Number 3 will recover the fucking reset. Huge pinch play. Logan Nichols with the fuck shot. Huge save by Trey Tompkins.
Looks like he didn't know where that was, but he did direct it out of play, so good for him.
Good for him. Offensive zone faceoff here for Lee Hockey Academy. We got Logan Nickerson taking the draw here. Michael Roby up top. Looks like it will go down low to Hoosac possession. Lee will recover. I don't think the puck will be in the Hoosac bench. West Coast K, number 10 on Hoosac, are out of the box here. Doesn't make a huge difference. It's still 5-on-5. Number 26 on Hoosac, taking the lead, number 17. Number 17 is wheeling down low. can make a shot with a field chip that's on. Huge, huge chip on number 13. What a pass, Logan Nickerson coming down the ice. Logan Nickerson, pass to Michael Robbie, shot. Big save by Trey Tompkins. Logan Nickerson will recover the puck here. Nickerson in front, Michael Robbie just missed. Huge chip at number 18 there. He'll get out to the top, looks like Nate. Down the Shea Theodore. Tip, play, rebound. Hoosac will recover the puck. Shea with the puck, just rushing it up. Hoosac getting a nice line change going. Attempted pass there to Brandon Marini, couldn't quite get to it. In front of that West, okay, shot. Is that a save there, or is that a miss?
That's a save. Trey Tompkins coming up big for the squad, even though they can't produce for him.
West okay with a face-off here. Off in the zone, down to Nate, down to Shea, shot, blocked. Number 16 on Hoosac will recover. Hoosac school is coming down. Number 23 will recover the puck down low. Huge hit by Nate Perizek. They're digging the puck down low. Who will come out with it? Who will come out with it? Looks like a lead just got a penalty. Looks like number 12, Nate Perizek, just got a penalty. Be a slasher a trip. Looks like Hoosac has an opportunity to show some offense off. We haven't seen it all game. Now they finally have a power play. Looks like there's some chatter in the penalty box. Face off on the blue line. Oh, and there's a stoppage of play already. Another jump score, I believe. These refs are calling everything. Duncan Treasure with a face off here. Only will recover the puck. Luke Stevens here. Quarterback in the play, and he's just trying to get it out. He's just trying to dump, playing some more hockey. Number 23 coming down with some dangles, and he will fall. And he recovers. Huge toe drag.
He's just toe dragging. Eventually he's going to lose the puck.
We're going to see him on Instagram later. Oh, never mind. Number 20 with the puck. Number 22. Chipping it down low in the lead end. Will they produce offense? Look at Trey with the puck. He's going to put up an absolute show here with that nice flick over the stick. Bumps it wide, just got Duncan Trace down low. Adam Cole passed down to Duncan Trace again, he's actually really down low. He is splitting between many defenders.
He's so good.
We got a lead opportunity to waste some time here. Looks like there's a minute left of this penalty. We got number 6 coming down on Hoosac, shot. Huge save by Keith Corbin. Huge jump by Troy Gouveia. 16 new member. Looks like we got number 11 skating the puck down wide, just trying to get it deep. And he will. Number 16 with the puck, forechecking. Elite is digging the puck out of the zone. They are trying to dig the puck out of the zone. Number 8 couldn't keep it in. Number 3 with the puck wide. And he passes it to no man's land. Elite with a nice clear there. We got 10 seconds left of this penalty. Hoosac will come out with the puck. Got number 3 on Hoosac wide. 6 in the net. Cut back play. We got Michael Ruby capping for a breakaway here. And the puck's in the netting.
.442 left in the third.
Looks like we had a 5-0 lead here. Will Cade Corbin get the shutout? Passing to Logan Nickerson. He will reset. Nice pass to Jack Vidier. Michael Roby with the puck. Michael Roby looks like he's been a quarterback this play. Nice move wide. Pop back. Logan Nickerson with the puck. Saucer attack of time. Disrupted by number 17. Nice play by Jack Vidier. Recovering the puck. Dangle number 25. He is going through everyone here. Succeed. Tim Madden on the forecheck here. That's in front, and it's covered by Hoosac's goaltender. Wesco K and the Ozone faceoff here. Yes. Oh, huge opportunity by Grant Amarlini. Grant Amarlini forechecking. So we have battle behind the net. Wesco K, he's there. Cut back play to reset by Hoosac. Nice little pass number 10. They're all really resetting. Nice little move. Pass to number 11. Wesco K will recover the puck. Wesco K coming down. Pass in front. Will it?
No.
With 3:07 here to go on the clock, maybe they'll just add more to the amount of goals that are just coming in. It's just an influx of goals. So many goals.
It's like an ocean. It's just waving in.
It's like a tsunami of points and goals and assists.
It's constant. Joker Church here with the offensive zone face-off on the power play for the Hockey Academy. Shane Theodore with the puck, quarterbacking in. Then the Wesco K. Wesco K looking for an opening, looking for someone to get open. Pass it back up to Dylan Contreras. Cliche, pass to Nate. Dylan Contreras is calling for the puck, and he missed. He wants that puck. Not afraid to call for it there. Shane keeping the puck in. Michael Roby down the West, okay. It's a game of Geepley right now. Oh, right into Tompkins' chest, though, right there.
Looking at his D-man, just with a look of, honestly, what felt to me was just disgust of just leaving these back door open. Honestly, lucky that nothing got through.
Delco Trashy with offensive zone faceoff. Ali will pinch and recover. Looks like West really wants that puck. Michael Trash trying to come out with the puck. Michael Roby, a shot. What a snipe by Michael Roby.
Bullet from the short side angle. Wow, and if the Hoosacs weren't already sad, that ought to do it.
I can't imagine what the goaltender's thinking after that one.
All. And just with that Selly as well, the slinger.
Jack Doherty here, the face-off center ice. I Adam Coley with the puck, tipping it up. Hey! You shit!
Dirty head for number 19. He's just salty that he's losing 6-0. He should be ashamed of himself.
Jack Doherty is trying to throw the body around. He is very mad. He is getting off the ice before something happens. He looks very shooken up after that one. This game is getting very chippy. There's a lot of hitting on the Hoosac end coming. Nick Fall with the puck down low. 14 pinning him against the wall. 25 coming down. Liam Delphin with the puck. Liam Delphin coming out with the puck. They're just trying to body them right now. Nick Fall with the dump. Nick Fall will be on the forecheck here. Trying to angle him. Let's go, K. Let's agree with the puck. He's on a one-on-one. Shot. I'm going to go away. What do you think about that one?
That's just a tough shot to see. You know, changing the angle always. These shooters are just evolving. It's crazy what they can do these days.
This is development here. That's what happens.
This game has evolved from a skill speed game to just an absolute brawl fest. I mean, this is just something that you don't love to see. Someone's bound to get hurt.
Yeah, like earlier in the game, we saw Brody True. Off the ice right now.
That's true, yeah. Daniel Berg, and you can't forget True Crew. Don't forget to subscribe on YouTube.
Michael Marquez with a face-off here. Jack Greene will cover the puck. Number 11 will recover. Cut back. Looking for someone that's open. Got number 3. Shot. Big. Oh, rock in front of the net. 38 seconds. Will K. Corbin get the shutout? Grant Amorlini. 1-on-2.
Don't jinx him like that, Nolan.
I have confidence in Kate Corbin here.
So do I. He's a great goaltender from Minnesota, born and raised.
We got a showdown.
We got 20 seconds here, one down in the game. This is for sure a win for the Elite Hockey Academy. But there's all just one question lingering in our minds.
A lot of physical action here. Michael Marquez with a beautiful hit.
That's a clear.
Seven seconds left.
Great game from the Elite Hockey Academy. It's just Nolan and Tommy signing out. Just, yeah, great game.
Great game.
That's my boy right there.
Ali will take it home.